Welcome. We're back. Episode number, I believe this is 7. I might be wrong, but I mean, you see that in the header anyway. World Brewers Championship Boston. We're reflecting, we're thinking, we're sharing what we did. Take it or leave it. At least we want to give you the opportunity to get an insight in the process. This time it's about the compulsory round. Compulsory round, undoubtedly where I fucked up this year. What did fuck up mean? I think it was 69.9 points or 70 points, whatever, which basically this year made me more or less average. So it wasn't bad. It wasn't very good. It was just in the middle of everyone. And I lost with 0.9 points. The winner had the highest open in the score in the competition. So of course I could push my open up as well, but let's face it, compulsory should have been better. A few things that were challenging this year. I think the biggest challenge here was that the coffee was very different. So, and before I go into this, this is not me complaining. I already made a post on Instagram and I saw some other people, they're talking about complaining, filing, official complaints or whatever. That's not what we're talking about here. I'm actually really happy that this was a challenge. It's a learning curve. It's an opportunity to get better. The difference here was that there is a few specifications. Well, the difference from Brazil, because I won the compulsory in Brazil, and I've been winning 3 other compulsories in national competitions from that, coaching other people as well. But then in Brazil or in Boston, we go there and we don't win and we don't do very well. And a big part of that is that in the rules, there is a specification of what the coffee should be for compulsory. Now, should there be a specification? Not necessarily. I don't think it cares. So again, this is not the point. The point is not I'm angry that the coffee was different from the specifications. I think that one can just as well argue, just skip the specifications and just give people a random coffee, and that will make everything a lot more interesting, right? So compulsory is about showing, you know, how much in control of a brewer you are and what you can do with the coffee you're not familiar with. Your open service is supposed to be very good because you had all the time in the world to practice. It's your coffee. It's your brew method. You chose exactly how to do things. It should be good. Compulsory, however, that's, you know, is a bit of a mystery. And of course, you can practice on this. The reality is that the coffee we brought was not a wash processed coffee. If that was a wash processed coffee, then I don't deserve to be a coffee roaster. And then, you know, nothing I know is right in this industry. Someone will probably say it's a wash processed coffee, but this was a really funky coffee with tons of natural processed character. So I would be very surprised if this would fall under the category of a wash processed coffee. It simply wasn't. The varietal in itself, honestly, I don't really know what it is. It's something that I'm not familiar with. It's not your average varietal. There were different thoughts about being Lorina, some kind of hybrid for sure, I would say. It looked very small, very long, similar to Lorina, but in a small version, probably from a dwarf tree. I don't know, it doesn't really matter. Also much lighter roasted than the coffee in Brazil. And the issue is here from our perspective, which we know now, and you know, competing is the only way to figure this out, was that I went into this competition relying on the rules, thinking that this coffee would be similar to other compulsory coffee previously in the history of the competition, which has been the case. I've been backstage on a lot of these and trying the compulsory coffees, and they would always fall within the same kind of category of a slightly over-roasted, burned, wash process, simple, like 82 coffee. And now we end up with a light roasted, natural processed coffee of a varietal. We don't really know what it is, which basically throw me off completely and throw the judges off completely as well. I talked with a lot of competitors afterwards, and there's almost no one that got scored consistently. So almost all people have a differences of at least 3 to 4 points between the highest and the lowest in what they got on the same 3 cups. And with the quality of the brewers in this competition, I don't believe that's a brewing fault. I don't believe we all just got a different reply from the judges because the brews were inconsistent. I believe this was a green coffee that was extremely inconsistent. So that's basically where we failed. We had a pretty good practice round when I think we actually got a relatively tasty coffee. We tried a few different brew methods, ended up with the AeroPress again, dilution. A dilution that extracts about 8% of the coffee. Again, the worse the coffee, the lower the extraction is the point, right? And then just diluting for a strength that is the strength that we're looking for. And we're pretty happy. It tasted actually pretty good, I think, at least pretty solid. I mean, it's always fun to see what other people can do with it. And there were some people that did obviously some pretty amazing stuff because they scored really high, right? Which is fantastic. I think in hindsight, what we should have done is that we should have competed with a very, you know, a wider range of coffees. And just a cautious for you guys out there, you know, it's Compulsory is changing, right? It's not, we can't rely on the coffee being the same. It's obviously not the same. And again, I don't say that from a frustrated perspective. I think the competition is more fun if we don't know what we're going up against. I think that's part of the game. And I mean, we should get a coffee that we're not familiar with. So I don't mind that process, but for you competing again from, let's say, from Boston to a new competition or competed before, the Compulsory coffee is not the same as it used to be. It's a different ballgame, and you need to change your brewing accordingly. With that, as I mean, same for everyone as well, the water quality in Boston was just not up to scratch. And again, I don't mind that because it's the same for everyone. So that's why I think Compulsory is an amazing, you know, it's an amazing part of the competition, and I think it helps you really bring out the best winner because you need to be very good at both, right? So I actually think it's a great system. Some kind of details about my approach, something I always do, I always dose up during my competition time, my setup time. Is it 8 minutes? Yeah. I dose up my doses. In this case, I use 33 grams. Grind them, always grind the coarsest, always. I don't necessarily change that. And then I just smell on all of them. And I think even here, it was so obvious that this coffee was, you know, a bunch of Quakers, bunch of not nice things. Which, I mean, it's sad when I know some other competitors have scored very, very low on Compulsory with the results. Yeah, it was a Quaker in there. And then it's like, should we on a World Brewers level have to deal with that? Should we, you know, or should we have a coffee that is just a clean coffee without any Quakers in it? One can argue that it gets more difficult with Quakers, then just sort that out, which I can kind of agree with as well. It's just, I think we need to maybe specify this a bit more so that everyone knows what they're getting themselves into. And just getting the judges calibrated on the same kind of page because it was obviously a huge range there. But yeah, smell through the grounds and take the one that smells the best, right? And there's a huge difference. Brewed pretty stable, low temperature brews always. We were down below 80 degrees. Concentrate. Basically just regulating the strength of that brew with the amount of water I pour on. Another thing that was really strange with the competition, I don't understand why they do this, is that they actually have glass. And I think you should be very aware of that because you served in glasses. You didn't serve in cupping bowls, meaning that the liquid becomes extremely clear, as in you can see exactly the color, the shape, the structure of the liquid. Which is, you know, we all know by now that liquid or how that liquid looks has a big impact on taste quality. We know that by now. So why in the world on a world stage they would serve coffees in a glass is an absolute mystery to me. Also, again, very different from Brazil. When talking with some of the head judges afterwards, the reply is basically, well, it often comes down to sponsorship. And I mean, I still think that's, we need to come up with a decision here and people need to decide how serious do we want to take this competition. I mean, it's also in all fairness and reality, we're kind of off topic here, but let's say it anyway, we're on the brewer stage in the final presenting and, you know, sometimes the judges can't hear us because barista is on at the same time and the stage is 10 times as big in the same room. So, I mean, it's clearly that the SEA is not favoring the Brewers Champion the Brewers competition, right? And I mean, I think it's I think that's a bit sad because we have a lot of interest in that competition, and people need to put it on a platform that it deserves. And then we need to move away from this randomness where, like, you go there and there's glasses, or you go there and the benches are obviously way too low for at least 90% of the competitors. I know that there's also, I mean, obviously there's shorter competitors, and that works the other way around where, you know, it's not fair that it should be too high for them either. I understand and I respect that. Maybe then we should have, you know, the competitors can choose the height of the table. The competitor can choose if they're just standing or sitting, more similar to where barista is now, right? There's definitely some things we can improve. But back to compulsory, just to round it up, aeropress brew after practice, practices the day before, which is always a bit risky, so you never really know how the grinder is going to behave the day after. Always work with cold water, not with hot water. You don't want water standing in the tower. And make it on time and be consistent. Read the rules. There's still so many questions about the compulsory ground that people are asking before the competition. I mean, if you're in the World Championship, you better know the rules. I mean, we should know the rules. So, and know that, you know, the people you have around you are just people. So timekeepers maybe don't really know. I instruct my timekeepers to basically shout at me the times I'm telling them, right? I have my own timer as well, but I mean, they need to be so fucking clear with time. So, I mean, have that, you know, respect that and realize that you need to give really clear instructions as well. That's about it. Compulsory round, the hardest part, train a lot on it. Diversify, that's what I'm going to try to do now, to be a lot more diverse than what I've done in the past. With that, I want to say thank you guys for watching. And as always, if you have questions, just write it down here.